Traders, Monday morning, my first trading day this week, and I'm done trading. Here's the results. Let's go through a short recap here. I've got over 2 grand in ARWR, Baba, nice trade, Disney, KL. So far, a loser in Nvidia. We'll go through this soon, but not necessarily going to stay a loser. A very small winner in SQ and a loser in Uber. I'm going to finish my day. I mean, so far, I'm up $3,300. So that's a great start for me. Very nice start for the week. Let's quickly go through some of my trades. So we did have KL, and hold on. I start with KL. KL was still is down. I mean, it's down 16% right now. Let me take it to 1 minute candles here so we can see that a bit more clearly. So here's KL. KL came down. We missed that move. We couldn't join it. You never join a stock as it's coming down because you don't chase a stock down. These are 1 minute candles. It was on my list. I would have gladly shorted it, but I couldn't because it came down. But once it pulled back up and came down again, it was posted right here. The reason why I don't have a big winner in KL, just $800 or so, is because I posted it here under 40-50 and I didn't really trust it that much. I started trusting it a bit when I saw this green candle here and then another red candle, and it proved to me it wants to come down. So I said, okay, I'm going to get in with small size. And I did, and it came down nicely. It didn't do much afterwards, as you can see, but it was enough to have a partial there and a winner. So we took the second pullback here after missing the first one for justified reason. We couldn't join. I do have a loser today in Uber. That's so far my only loser. I would not call Nvidia my loser. And Uber was traded for a short under 2860. So 2860 was right over here. It did come down to 2838, but it wasn't enough. So I was looking for more, and that just wasn't enough for a partial. And then it moved up and took me out. And as you can see, Uber so far is uptrending. Maybe now it looks a bit better. I mean, some of you asked me earlier if they should short Uber. I still think it's not a good idea. It came up, as you can see, at the point where it closed the gap. That is very common for stocks. At the point where it closed the gap, this is yesterday's close. So at that point, right over here, it bounced and came down. And this becomes now a resistance point, and it comes down again. So if you ask me whether you should short a stock that came up and closed the gap, my answer is no. In my opinion, it's not a good idea. Uber proved to us that it started with a gap down today, and it's very, very strong. I think we can definitely find some better short opportunities, like in my opinion, we saw earlier. What was it? Beyond, of course. So, several more trades today. Disney was an interesting long trade. Posted this one over 148, 70. Let's try to see it. A bit more details. 148.70. So Disney was at that point over here. So initially it came down quite strong. Then it moved up quite strong. And I was asked somewhere in the room whether we should go long here. I said no because that was a bit extended. But then it came down and I was following it. So then we moved in over 148.70, which was right over here somewhere, actually here. Okay, I can't remember exactly when. And then it moved up quite nicely, and that became a winner. The really nice thing about Disney is the daily. Look at the daily. I mentioned KL earlier, and KL was a beautiful daily, which looks quite similar. Hold on a second. Was it KL? No? Hold on. No, not KL. What was it? Well, not KL. Anyway, let's go back to Disney. This huge move up, a consolidation near the highs, and possibly move to a new high, that looks like a great looking daily. So if you take a look at Disney and you find a good intraday entry point, and because the daily looks like it is, then Disney is a good opportunity, and it did work out. My best trade today is ARWR. Over 54.50 is where I posted it. So take a look at this trade over here, 54.50. 50. It was right over here. So this one was right away noticed. The stock is up right now 20%. Well, it was maybe 15%, over 10%, somewhere over here. And it keeps going up. So it recently just touched my 5-point profit. And ARWR initially came up, tried to move lower, failed, nice technical reversal, and then to the skies. So that was really beautiful and my best trade today. So again, the stock is up 20%. What does it mean? It means a lot of people are watching it today. So it has, as you can see, 2.5 million shares volume, and it's moving up. It's up almost 20%. Of course, it wasn't at 20%, but you know, people are screening for stocks which are over 1%, 5%, 10%. So it comes out on everyone's screeners, and therefore you can trust it as it moves to a nice into at a point of a nice technical formation. You can trust that there will be a lot of people who do the same thing as you do, because you know, technical analysis is not much more than a self-fulfilling prophecy, and that's it. So ARWR was followed by a lot of people, and they joined you and helped you at a nice technical point. Another nice long trade was Baba over 189.50. So it was initially here 189.50, and that did not work out. But again, a very nice technical formation, beautiful move up. Baba is up right now 1.6%. Over 1%, it means people are watching it. The 1% mark is the most important one. And then it came down, and then it tried to move lower, failed, came up again, moved over the 50 mark right over here. Did not do much, but hasn't done anything wrong. We managed this one correctly. We knew exactly what our stop is going to be, and it kept coming up. So it had and still has a very nice technical formation, moved up, we got a partial and a beautiful winner. I do have Nvidia here, which this trade is not concluded yet. Posted over 221, a whole number. And this is just a beautiful breakout formation. Just very, very pretty breakout formation, but did not do much. The interesting thing about this 221 move is that once the stock, like Nvidia, moves to a new high, you expect a very quick move. And look at the volume here. It happened with a lot of volume too. So this big upside move was 37 cents. Now, I knew that once it's going to move over 221, a whole number, it's going to run, and I did not want to chase it up. That's why on some rare occasions, like today, I used a limit order. You don't usually see me using a limit order because I trade CFDs and I have unlimited liquidity that I can buy with CFDs. But the thing is, sometimes when the stock is jumping over a whole number, it can run really quickly. And I didn't want to chase up Nvidia 20 cents or 30 cents. So what I did was using a limit order. So I was doing something like this. And of course, my quantity was very small. It's a big mover. I was expecting a $1 pullback, potential $1 pullback. And we always were there. We're still uptrending. So I keep hoping it's going to get back to green territory, and it's very much close to it right now. So it's just about to move over 21. So the order I used was a limit order at 221.07, and I missed the breakout. I clicked the button a bit too late, and of course it happened very quickly because again of the 221 mark, and I did not want to chase it up. So I used a limit order, a buy limit order, and when it came down a bit, I joined. I mean, the limit order was there. The thing you need to remember about this kind of order is that if you use a limit order at a breakout, wait a bit. First, the first few seconds could get you into a trade. Usually, the first few seconds will get you into a trade, and then most likely, it will return to the highs, which did not happen in Nvidia. Well, you never know. It was not a wrong trade. It was the right thing to do, Nvidia. But it came down a bit too much, and now it's trying to make its way back up again. But again, if you join and click a limit order, wait a bit. Don't wait usually more than 30 seconds, because if you wait a bit too much, then the pullback may be a bit more, and it was a bit more than just a pullback. So usually, it's a quick move over the highs. If you're lucky, it's going to come down very quickly to your limit order and take you in, and then it's very likely to continue higher. Was it wrong to do? No, it was not, although I'm a bit down right now with Nvidia, but it's uptrending. Therefore, I believe that it's more likely for me to finish NVIDIA in green territory than in red. Right now, it's a bit down, no big deal. But as you can see, if I count out NVIDIA so far, which I still believe it's going to finish in green, then I've got one, two, three, four, five green trades and one loser in Uber, which makes it a very nice trade day, trading day in my opinion. So nice success rate. Love to start my week with such a green day, over 3 grand. And I want to thank you all for participating and joining me today. So hope you're going to have some fun in the remaining of your trading day today, and I'll see you all tomorrow. So just be careful out there. Trade, don't overtrade. I just noticed that I a bit overtraded today, 7 trades. That's a bit too much, but still success rate is quite good even for that. Thank you very much for joining. Thank you guys on YouTube for joining us, and we would really appreciate your thumbs up in YouTube if you don't mind giving us. That will help our channel, and I'll see you all tomorrow. Bye, traders.
Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to take Trader's free welcome course. It was designed to teach you the basics of Wall Street trading. Click here to sign up for this no risk, no cost offer. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.